All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is it, the moment you've all been waiting for. Let's get right down to it. Ah, shit. You know what? I'm gonna name myself something super, super, super original. Hang on. I just came up with the greatest idea ever. Huh? Huh? I bet you Nintendo never thought of that one. Alright, I'm gonna try to not to spoil any of the cutscenes in this game. I'm just gonna let this play. It just tells such a really great story. In case you didn't figure it out, they're talking about Navi. Alright, I'll shut up now.
Oh.
So you should probably gather. Situation is a little dire right now. I'm just gonna fix the color just a little bit. Hang on. There we go. It looked okay in the video, but on my television is kind of terrible, so I couldn't really see that well. I'm actually doing this in my bedroom now, as opposed to where it used to be. It was in the living room. Oh, we all know you can't figure shit out. So this is Tattle or Tail. I totally just forgot. She just said her name and I totally forgot it. In any case, this fucking fairy, you're gonna fucking learn to hate this fairy. There's a great, interesting personality. There's a lot of depth to her, but you're gonna be missing Navi for the rest of your life. Now, I know everybody's like, oh my god, Navi's so annoying, and I thought so too. But then I got this fucking poor excuse for a fairy, and I go, oh my god, Navi was so informative, this fairy doesn't know shit. You go, okay. Like, I don't know. You go to Navi, and he's like, okay, you need to take the bombs and throw it at them at this specific angle, and then you have to follow it up with a sword slash for a 63 degree turn. He's like, I don't know. All right, so yeah, this, as you can probably tell, this is kind of interesting. I'm a fucking Deku scrub. So one of the things that I very oftentimes had to defeat. Deck color. Okay, here we go. And this is one of my powers, apparently. So everybody knows, I reiterate, this is my favorite Zelda of all time, and it is the only Zelda that made it into my top 10 favorite games of all time. I think it comes in at number 9 out of my 10. I took a lot of risks with this game, and it really paid off. So that's I don't want to spoiler alert, just in case anybody doesn't really like. Okay, if it's not really much of a spoiler, just FYI, but that's a dead Deku scrub. That's what Dekus do when they die. They turn into this kind of tree thing, and you know what? I'm gonna save the spoiler for later, for when it makes more sense. But for now, let's just keep moving.
Thank you.
to this song. It's gonna get stuck in your head. There ain't a damn thing you can do about it. I'm not shitting you. I mean, it's a really good, catchy jingle, but there's no Oh, look, it's Tingle's first debut. He's even uglier in this game than he is in other ones. Jesus fucking Christ. Look at that. Is that a clock around his neck? Is he fucking Flava Flav? What the sniznat? Holy crap. And the closer you look at him, the more polygonal you realize he is. He didn't really look that polygonal back in the day. I mean, you know, he didn't seem it anyway. But yeah, no, this song is going to be stuck in your head for like the rest of your life. I mean, 10 years from now, you're going to remember that the entire jingle in your head. Seriously, like, so where I am right now is called Clock Town. You're gonna see a lot of familiar faces, like, that's the guy I gave the bunny hood to. There's a lot of theories around why all these characters are the same exact ones from Ocarina of Time. Personally, I like to just go with the fact that there's just a lot of people who look alike. For the most part, you can just explain it away that way. Now, granted, a lot of them have the same names as those people. So, like the alternate reality theory, I don't like the Link is Dead theory. I'm not sure what all I know is I like to believe that this really and truly is Link's next adventure, and it's 100% canon. I feel like this is where this version of Link ended his journey. So, first thing we're gonna do is... Although I'll admit, the whole jingle thing that the fairy does is a lot less annoying than, "Hey, listen, what's up? Look!" By the way... Oh, okay. Alright. Oh yeah, no, that's not nightmare fuel at all. No, I won't have any problems sleeping tonight. No, I'll be good. I'll be just fine. I'm gonna be just fine. Anyway, this place is called Clock Town. And, everybody works on a schedule in this town, which I find really, really interesting. Every character works on a schedule. You won't see that kind of shit in a game again until, like, Elder Scrolls comes out with, like, Morrowind. But yeah, I really don't like the theories that, you know, Link is dead. I don't like the theories that say this is an alternate universe. Like these guys. These guys were always in Hyrule Castle. No, I really and truly like to think that this is, you know, the last adventure that this Link went on. They need to have more direct sequels, honestly. Especially ones without Ganon being the villain. And if they were as psychotic and interesting and just pure evil and haul ass like Majora, yeah, no, I would totally love that. Thank you. Yeah, apparently Dekus don't like water. Yeah, Majora is just psychotic. Okay, think about it. Now, I won't tell you things about Majora yet because you didn't like really learn enough, but one thing that differentiates him from Ganondorf is that Ganondorf just wants to rule the world because Ganondorf is Ganondorf. Majora is much more simplistic than that, and that doesn't make him a better character, but he makes him far more interesting because they use Ganon in pretty much every goddamn Zelda game. Now, I know that a lot of the 2D ones, that there are different ones like Vahati and stuff, but, you know, I know that the 2D ones are good. I've played a few. I've almost beat one of them. But I really, really, really am sick to death. I can only really get invested in the 3D ones. Not that there's anything wrong with the 2D ones. But I'm really, really sick of seeing Ganondorf as my villain at the end of every fucking 3D Zelda game. I want to get immersed, but I also want to not have to fight Ganondorf at the end of every fucking game. So that's why I'm a huge fan of this game. Oh, if you didn't know, Ganondorf wasn't going to be the villain in this game. Sorry, spoiler alert. So this guy is the bank teller. He wasn't the bank teller in the last game, but he is now, so suck it. So this is actually, the way this works is actually very interesting, but I will explain it later. Just mean, does it sound like he's jerking off whenever he hits his lap? Oh well. All right, so I'm gonna head back to the Great Fairy over here. Which, by the way, I know that, you know, I know the fairy said that Skull Kid does not stand a chance against the Great Fairy. Well, with that mask on him, he didn't just defeat the Great Fairy, he broke her. And somehow in my mind's eye, I imagine it went something like, oh, there you go. I imagine it went something like he literally just went up to her and just fucking roundhouse kicked her in the face, and then she broke into all these different parts. Like almost Chuck Norris style, but like just not as comedic. Just one solid fucking hit, and she just immediately broke like water into this, you know, all these different weird looking face fairies. Yeah, they have faces on them. That's a little weird, but I like the originality. Oh yeah, there are great fairies here in Terminio too. By the way, I'm not in Hyrule. I'm in a different part of the world, which is another thing I like to differentiate with a lot of other people. They say that this is a parallel universe because you end up going into a tree and then coming out of a cave or whatever, or coming out of a windmill, or I'm sorry, a clock tower. I think there's plenty of ways to explain that, but more importantly, I like to think that Terminia is just a different part of the Earth, and Hyrule cannot possibly be the entire planet, so... He cunt-punted you. What, did they run out of red hair dye? Dude. Oh my god. So high. Okay, well, that happened. He cunt punted the great fairy. Alrighty. Snap bubble powers, go! Yeah. I'm badass, I know. I think I could probably remember the code. I don't think it's randomized. I think it's the same code every time you play the game. I could probably just figure out the code and use it to get to where I need to go, but I'm here to show you guys how to play the game, not how to, you know, on a regular playthrough. I'm not showing off or trying to save time or anything. I just want to entertain a little bit. Oh my dear God, they're all the same. So basically, we're going to be playing hide and go seek. Yeah, I'm just going to adjust the color just a little bit because I think it's perfect on my television set. It just needs to be a little bit darker. Oop, that's way too dark. Give me 1 second. I'm going to adjust the television itself. I'm going to see if we can... Oops. Okay. Oh well, I think that'll just have to do. Television's kind of shitty, but I don't want to ruin it for you guys. Although it kind of looks a little bit better on my television set than it, with the brightness. But your recording has better color right now, so it kind of evens out a little bit. Alright, so I found one. Shitty ass hiding spot, by the way. Okay, this is part of another quest, so I can't do shit. Nope. You know what you do when you see someone getting mugged? Get the fuck out of there. Gotta find us some little boys. That didn't sound right. But I stand by it. We're gonna find us our little boys. And then once we find them, we'll get the ultimate prize, which is, we get to rape them. I'm I'm sorry. Did that come out? Wow, did I say that out loud? Holy shit. Oh, yeah, this controller works a lot better. Never use bootleg controllers. Even if they feel better in your hands. I just wish you guys could see how dark this is on my screen. It's actually the perfect depth of darkness. Okay, alright, so I've gone in a complete circle. I'm actually going the wrong way here. About to run out of time for shit. Okay, how many more are there? Fuck, I wasn't paying. I totally ironic. I'm always the one preaching about keep track of your time. And then shit like this happens. And now I got it's okay. It's cool. It only take me a second to do the hide and seek thing over. See, this shouldn't be a problem for people. You know what, I really despise people who hate this game strictly based on the fact that there's a time limit. It's too hard. I can't do it in time. Yeah, bullshit. Okay, I'm gonna show you how you can beat this game with all the time you need. First things first, let's go catch this guy. You can run, but you can't hide, little boy. Oh, there's the other guy. Kids know how many of them are left. Wow, there's another one. How do the kids know how many of themselves are left? Seriously, though. They're like, oh my god, I was caught. There's two left. How do you know? Sorry, I've been dicking around with the color of my screen. Let's see. Did I call? Did I get? No, I didn't. There you are, you little bastard. Wow, racism at its finest. So that's how you can tell these kids apart. Oh, okay, no. Actually, the number is randomized, but I think there's only two or three different codes. So it's only randomized between two or three different codes that are possible. I'm going to use that code to get past their guy who's actually guarding this little alleyway here. Yeah, I went back and checked the footage, so sue me. I probably still won't get it right. Oh, I did get it right. Okay. Here I am, still dicking around with equipment. Not bubble, go! Thank you. You know, we're not gonna just, we're just gonna sit here and not question how it is that a moon, which is a body of, you know, rock, a spherical body of rock, is able to produce a tear. And I don't care if the tear is made of stone or gems or whatever. It came directly out of his eye. You don't find that even slightly weird? I mean, it makes me wonder, is the moon alive? Or does it just have a face just for the sake of being creepy? I wonder why Nintendo went with that. They didn't have to put a face on the moon. Could have just as easily finished the entire game without putting a face on the moon. It held no real plot significance. Although I guess it does give you a bit more of a feeling of dread. Alright. So the idea, we want to get to the top of the clock tower and meet up with Skull Kid, who has Majora's mask on his face. And it is slowly but surely kind of changing him. So this guy, there's a few of these golden Deku flowers around Terminia. Shit. And these little golden ones, they actually send you really far up into the air compared to the regular ones. And they're all owned by these pretentious, like, rich Deku scrubs. And each one of them has the deed to it. And there are different things you can do to make them sell you the deed. And in this case, I'm going to give him a moon tear. I wish I could move out of a house that quickly. Holy shit, man. Like, seriously. He just had his shit off. Alright, and so the rest of this is just waiting. So I'm just gonna speed this up for you guys. And we'll just bring it back to normal speed once it's time. Thank you. God, the world's ending. Okay, so the moon is falling. And we is all gonna die. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Oh wait. Snot bubble! Go! Take that. Yoink. She did what now? Wait. None of this makes any fucking sense. I'm sure they could have found a way around it, but really they didn't explain. Okay, well, first off, I gave the Ocarina of Time, which belonged to past Zelda, to future Zelda, back in time. So future Zelda actually has past Zelda's Ocarina of Time. So past Zelda shouldn't have her Ocarina of Time. Furthermore, the Ocarina of Time that belongs to future Zelda hang on, time travel hurts my brain, is currently locked away with Link while he sleeps, right? I don't fucking know. I don't know. Fuck it. Who the hell is the goddess of time? Oh yeah, the world is still ending. Oh my god! I'm just gonna pull this right the fuck out of nowhere. It's coming out of my anus. You saw my playthrough of Zelda, right? We all know damn well the Song of Time did not have this effect. I mean, I'll give it a pass because it's cool as shit, but still, this is not what the Song of Time did. Never mind, we're just gonna, for the sake of moving on, I'm just gonna let that slide. Okay. No. Where the fuck did that piano come from? You did not just pull that out of your bag. I will let a lot of things slide in Zelda, but that might be a bit much. Although, it could have been in here already. I didn't really get a good look around. Yeah, I used this as my scarecrow song in the last game. Shut up. Oh, I'm handsome again. Thank God. About that. Well, no. Jesus Christ! Well, I feel like I got a taste of it, you know, considering he threw the fucking moon at me. Is this guy bipolar or some shit? Okay. Is this like one of those motivational seminars? Oh yeah. Oh yeah, turning on to those right now. Fine. With that, ladies and gentlemen, I believe that concludes my first episode. I hope you liked what you saw. This is only the very tip of the iceberg. I know it was a little bit, I know the
events that transpired were just a little bit lacking in luster and, you know, wasn't all that much, but I promise you, coming down the line will be plenty of entertainment. But for now, I'm signing off.